What's going on, guys? So it's Monday afternoon. I'm down here in the basement trying to find the motivation to keep it going. So what's going on? So the purpose of this video series, if you've been following it, is to document my progress on trying to build up to a 420-pound bench press. And my goal was to hit that in the upcoming powerlifting meet that I'm going to do July 27th. So basically, I got a good bench press. Everything else sucks. So I'm trying to strengthen my strength. Why is that? You should try to build up your weaknesses, right? But because I'm trying to do it for YouTube. So, I mean, nobody's interested in seeing me build up a weak squat or build up a weak deadlift. So I figured, let me show people how good I am at bench press, document my progress on that, and maybe get a couple views. I don't really even get views anyway. But anyways, what happened? Last year, I did the same thing. I didn't build up to 420-pound bench press. I did a 402-pound bench press, and I took the record and the 198-pound weight class in the USPA Connecticut state records. This year, I'm trying to do full all-around powerlifting. I did the powerlifting meet last year, but I just wasn't focused on squats or deadlift. I barely even trained them. I just went to meet and did whatever I could do. This year, I'm trying to really take it seriously. So I was doing low bar squatting 3 times a week, deadlifting 3 times a week, and bench pressing 3 times a week. But what happened is, if you've been following the series, you know I started aggravating on my bicep tendons. They start flaring up, getting really inflamed, and it stops me from bench pressing. So I don't know about that 420-pound bench press. This is supposed to be my last week of training and then just deload and go into the meet. But right now, I can't even bench press. So what I'm doing is I'm trying to build up my weakness. My weakness is squats. I got this buffalo bar behind me. I'm up to, I think, 364 pounds right now. The bar with the clamps on it is 50 pounds. So, I'm just trying to build up my weakness. I can't bench press. So you might be saying, wait a minute, I thought low bar squatting is what irritated your bicep tendons. Yeah, that's why I went and purchased this Buffalo bar. It's like a poor man's version of the Duffalo bar by Chris Duffin. And I'm also putting my hands way out at the plates, and because of the camber on it, I'm able to put my hands lower so it doesn't irritate my elbows at all. And it's going to strengthen up my squats, because if I, whatever I could squat with this, I could squat more, I'm going to think, with a straight bar. Because this is like, I feel like it, maybe I'm wrong, but to me it feels like it's in between a safety squat bar and a regular bar. And with the safety squat bar, I really get pulled forward. I really feel it in my upper back. With this one, it's like, it's not as bad. It's not as pronounced as the safety squat bar, but I still feel it pulling me forward, especially when I'm breaking it and I'm doing the walkout. I can really feel it trying to fold me over. So I feel like this is an advantage. Anything I can hit with this bar, I can smoke with a straight bar. So anyways, long story short, or a long story longer, I'm down here on doing this squats, because even deadlifts on Friday were irritating my elbows. You could say, like, how could that be? I don't know. They just got to that point where they're really bad. So I'm only using this bar right now, squat. This is all I'm doing. But I need to do something or something for the chest. I just can't give it a complete break. So later today, I'm going to go to the gym. And this is crazy. 2 weeks out from the meet, supposed to be my last week of training. I should be focusing strictly on the competition lifts, no variations. But I'm going to have to go to the gym and hit, like, some hammer press machines and some dumbbells. Those are, like, the only things for chest that don't irritate my elbows. And then I'm going to train one last time next Monday, the week of the meet, and I'm going to hit all the competition lifts, deadlift, regular bar, straight bar, regular power bar, squats, and bench press. I'm also going to do deadlifts on Wednesday. I'm going to deadlift Wednesday and Monday, and I'm not going to bench press at all until Monday. So I'm only going to bench press one more time to the competition. I haven't bench pressed since last Wednesday. And I did 385, and it felt horrible on my elbows. And 385 should be easy for me. I should be able to hit that anytime. So I feel like what's really going on is my elbows are holding me back more than anything, because I hit 385 like 6 weeks ago when I wasn't even training bench press. I just went into the gym and just on a whim just smoked that. So for it to feel heavier now is because my elbows are killing me. So I'm coming down all slow, shaking a little bit. All right, it's going on like 5 minutes. All I'm doing is talking. Let me get back to this. I got to just smoke this squat. It's always been my weak point. I got to change that. You know why it's been my weak point? Because I've always been scared of squats, because it's the one lift that I feel like if something goes wrong, you're just getting crushed. On a bench press, I've never been scared to go heavier than I should, because I felt like if anything went wrong, I could just sit it on my chest, even if I don't have a spotter. I feel like when you're going heavy in the gym, you always got a spotter because people are always watching you. And I feel like the worst that could happen is I just sit it on my chest and ask for some assistance, somebody run over and we just lift it up together. With a deadlift, it gets too heavy, you just let go. But with a squat, always like in the back of my mind, I'm always unwracking that thing, thinking if something goes wrong, bro, that's your spine. Like, you could get crushed. But I gotta get out of that way of thinking. I gotta just know, man, this is lightweight. I'm weak on this. I need to get out of that mind frame, man. It's in the mind. I gotta conquer that. All right, so anyways, just trying to control, own these squats, trying to show my mind that, no, you own this. Anything in the 300s is wimp weight. All right, let's go. Oh, and by the way, I'm sipping on a little cranky, taking it like this is a session IPA. Now, if you're unfamiliar with that, you know, we're gonna talk about things besides just lifting. Session IPA is because they came out with that. First of all, IPAs, Indian Pale Ales, they're stronger because they had to last that trip from Britain over to India for the soldiers. They had to maintain that flavor on that long voyage in the boats. Session IPAs come from when people were on their lunch breaks, their break session, they wanted a lighter beer. Their company would give them beer, but they didn't want drinking something too strong with alcohol, so they give them something with a lower alcohol content on their break sessions. That's where you get session IPA. So it's about 2 o'clock in the afternoon, just having a session IPA, keeping it easy, but still trying to find the motivation. All right, this is getting too long-winded. Let's go, let's go, let's get this motivation. Let's do this, let's smoke this. Another thing going on is no training partners. I'm down here alone. Down here alone. Now, squats is something, like I said, that was always in the back of my mind, that this is dangerous, that you might not get up. So I always look for a spotter. If I'm in the gym, I always will go ask for a spot. I got to get out of that mentality. I got to get out of the way that way of thinking. I got to understand that in the 300s, that's wimp weight, man. That shouldn't getting going down and coming up with something in the 300s on my back is not even a question. It's not even a question. So no. Send the training partners home today. Send the training partners home. I need to conquer this. Like I said, you got to face your fears. Got 370 on there right now. Man, that's lightweight. What am I even doing? How I'm over 200 pounds and I'm even considering this. Come on, man. Let's go. So like I was saying before my last set, I don't have a training partner today. Now, usually I'm training with my boy. At least one of my boys comes through to train. And everybody knows when you got somebody with you pushing you, it's always going to give you more motivation. It's always going to make you feel stronger. But what you got to do is you got to take anything that's a negative and turn it into a positive. Any type of handicap you have, you got to take that and you got to take advantage of that. Because, all right, for instance, I don't have somebody here with me today, right? So I feel like that's making it a little tougher for me. But look at how the mental aspect of it. Look how I'm attacking that problem. I just feel like if I could still do what I planned on doing with my training partner here, then how much stronger will I be when I do have somebody with me, right? When I do have somebody pushing me, when I do have somebody that I know got my back. If I could still do what I was going to do with him here, without him here, then what am I going to do on Wednesday when I do got somebody pushing me, right? So it's just like working with this bar. Like, this bar to me is a little trickier. I feel like it's pulling me a little forward. So I take that negative and turn it into a positive. I think about, okay, so if I could still crush what I need to crush with this bar, how much stronger am I going to be when I put the regular straight power bar on my back? And I gotta have my hands all the way out on the plates. But when I bring my arms in and I'm able to lock down those lats, how much stronger will I be coming up through that sticking point, right? So we take the negatives. And, you know, like I said, so much of it is just a mental game, man. And once again, sorry for the lighting down here. I know I'm in and out of shadows and stuff, but we don't care about that little stuff. Man, everything don't need to look pretty. Everything don't need to be perfect, man. Let's work through. Let's grind out. Let's go. 375 on here right now. Still lightweight, man. It's lightweight. I need to get out of this lightweight territory. It's time to start playing around for real with real weight. I don't know what happened to the audio on this one, so I'm just going to do a little voiceover for this here clip. But all right, so we're up to 381. The depth on this one looks good, but what I notice is on the way up, I'm getting a little bit of knee cave. I noticed that a couple weeks ago, so I started bringing my knees in a little bit right there. You see, that's what's called a double abduction. So I'm gonna try bringing my knees in still even a little bit more.
See walking on top of the devil's roof. Rap critics want a convert. Nice. About this.